I don't know that I've ever had a groom beat me up onto the stage. He's excited.
Keep up, and I can't back down. I've been losing so much time. 'Cause it's you and me, and all other people. Nothing to do, nothing to lose. And it's you and me, and all other people. And I don't know why I can't keep my eyes off of you. One of the things that I wanna say just aren't coming out right. I'm tripping on words. You got my head spinning. I don't know where to go from here. It's you and me, and all other people. Nothing to do, nothing to prove. And it's you and me, and all other people. And I don't know why I can't keep my eyes off of you. There's something about you now is beautiful. Everything she does is right. 'Cause it's you and me, and all other people. Nothing to do, nothing to lose. And it's you.
The days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want until your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too.
Don't get many things right the first time. In fact, I am told that a lot. Now I know all the wrong turns, the stumbles and falls brought me here. What if I'd been born 50 years before you?
Who gives this young woman to marry this young man?
Her mother and I.
We have gathered here this afternoon to share in the joy and excitement of Austin and Kelsey's wedding. We are honored to be witnesses of the covenant that they are making with one another before God. Let us call on God now to do only what He can do, to join these two together as husband and wife. Let's pray. Holy Father, we thank you for this special day, this gathering of family and friends, for this couple who are coming before you now to be joined together in the covenant of marriage. We pray that they will experience every joy of marriage that you established, ordained, and is blessed by you. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. Austin and Kelsey met online when Austin liked Kelsey's profile. We all know what that means now today, what that means to like a profile. Kelsey was just starting to open up to a dating again and thought, why not give this guy a shot? So they met at Blue Coast for lunch and then headed over to Stars and Strikes, where they bowled and played some arcade games. Kelsey was drawn to his carefree and joyous spirit, while Austin was attracted to her sweetness, laughter, and smile. They ended that first date with a kiss. Then Austin flew back to New York to visit family, while Kelsey traveled to Illinois to visit with a friend. It didn't take long before they were talking every day and getting to know each other on a deeper level. Austin was patient with Kelsey, and Kelsey encouraged her to enjoy life to the fullest. Kelsey was supportive and helped instill a sense of peace for Austin. Although they were very different, they were perfect in the way that they balanced one another. Then Austin asked Kelsey, big step here, to go to New York with him in February to retire from the military and to meet his family. Kelsey was a little hesitant because she thought this was a little too soon, but at the same time, she was very excited that Austin wanted his family to meet her. She had been praying that the future held a husband with a family that she could be close to. On this trip, their intentions were solidified and their desire to be together. They spent more time getting to know each other over the next few months and were engaged in May. My prayer for both of you is that you never stop getting to know each other, that you pursue one another, that you grow deeper and deeper in love with one another and God as you pursue a relationship with Him as a couple, as one. In 1 Peter 3, Paul challenges wives to respect their husbands. Kelsey, your respect for Austin is obvious in the way that you support him and give him peace. Likewise, Paul challenges husbands to love their wives. Austin, your love for Kelsey is apparent in your selfless acts of service and your gentle spirit. Protect that love and respect for each other. There are days that will come much easier than others. Never take it for granted. It is a sacred choice you make to choose your spouse over yourself. At this time, Austin and Kelsey have decided to share some vows with one another. And so I'm going to give a microphone to Austin.
Kelsey, you made me feel like the luckiest man in the world, or at least mine, because you are my world, and I couldn't picture it without you. There's not many words that could describe the love I have for you, and the love you have given me back ever since the first day we met at Blue Coast for our first date. When you asked me to meet your family for the first time by joining all of you at church, and ever since then, I've truly felt welcomed into the family, and today I'm happy to officially become a member of your family. I promise that I will always be there for you through the good times, but also the bad times. And I know as long as we're together, we can make it through any obstacle in our path. As said in the book of Hebrews 13:5, keep your life free from the love of money. Be satisfied with what you have, for he himself has said, I will never leave you or abandon you. To which I will promise to always love, cherish, adore, be patient, honest, and protect you until our time on this earth has come to an end. But even then, I know our love will continue for each other as we walk through the kingdom of heaven.
Austin, I knew I could love you the first time I met you. Your joy and zest for life was something I wanted to be a part of. You challenged me to live life to the fullest and to dream big. I promise not to dim that light and to be by your side for all your crazy adventures. I promise to love you and support you in everything you do. I promise to wake up every day and choose you. I promise to be faithful and to never stop reminding you why I love you. I promise to be by your side through all the ups and downs that life brings us. You are the love of my life, and I promise to adore you, cherish you, and respect you all the days of my life.
No kissing yet. We could end it right there. Okay. So today, not only are we joining Austin and Kelsey, but we're also bringing two families together. And so not only celebrating that union, but also the union of their families. We are going to have a sand ceremony. And the sand ceremony will include the blending of sands from their parents, symbolizing not only the love they have from one another, but also the support that they have from their families. In the containers over here to my right, Kelsey and Austin have selected sands of different colors, each representing the uniqueness and individuality they bring to this marriage. While they are retrieving and pouring the sand, a special song is going to be performed by Jeremy, Lincoln, Lillian, and Jameson.
One look at you, and my whole life falls in line. I prayed for you before I called you mine. Oh, I can't believe it. I get to love you. It's the best thing that I'll ever do. I get to love you. It's a promise I'm making to you. Whatever may come, but I will choose. Forever I'm yours, forever I do. I get to love you. I get to love you. The way you love, it makes me who I am. I am undone. It's heavy. get to love you. I get to love you. I get to love you.
I think it would be appropriate to applaud. That was awesome. That was so good. So, Austin, will you have Kelsey to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. Kelsey, will you love Austin? Will you have Austin to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. Jesus said, you read that at the beginning, the Creator made them male and female. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So you two are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate. The Apostle Paul calls this a profound mystery. In order to show that you belong to one another and to seal the vows you have made to one another, we are now going to exchange rings. And Austin, you're going to go first. Austin, will you take this ring and place it on Kelsey's hand? Go ahead and repeat this promise after me. With this ring, I seal my promise to be your faithful and loving husband with God as my strength. All right, Kelsey. Kelsey, take this ring and place it on Austin's hand and repeat this after me. With this ring, I seal my promise to be your faithful and loving wife.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
With God as my strength.
With God as my strength.
The Lord said, it is not good for man to be alone. I will make him a helper that is suitable for him. So the Lord caused the man to fall into a deep, deep sleep. And while he was sleeping, he took one of the man's ribs and closed up the place with flesh. Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib that he had taken out of man. And he brought her to man. The man said, this is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. Austin, Kelsey is now your wife. She is your helper. She is your better half. She has become bone of your bone and flesh of your flesh. Or as we say, she is now flesh and blood. You are to love her unconditionally and sacrificially as Christ loved the church. You are to treat her with kindness and gentleness and sensitivity. Kelsey is your joint heir in this gracious gift of life, meaning that you live your life together in a view toward heaven, and you do everything you can to make sure she goes to heaven, to be there with her. Kelsey, Austin is now your husband. Honor and respect him, encourage and support him. He is your joint heir in life. You must do everything you can to see that he gets to heaven. Let's all pray together. Father, we believe that you are personally involved in this ceremony today. You are the one who designed marriage and ordained it. It is one of your good gifts to us. We are thankful for the way you have made us male and female in your image. Help Austin and Kelsey to reflect your image, to seek you, to seek your will, and the things so that they may enjoy your goodness. Father, please protect them, protect their home from evil forces that would try to tear them apart. And may this marriage endure and flourish to your name's glory and honor. In Jesus' name, amen. And so, it is through faith in God's joining them together that I now pronounce Austin and Kelsey husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he give you peace. Friends and family, it is my pleasure to present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Van Avery. Join them down in the fellowship hall for a meal following our ceremony. You are dismissed.